Hi friends, here in this video I'll be explaining a problem on gas turbine with regeneration, and here is the question. Whatever is given in this question, I'll write that in the form of data. It is given: a gas turbine takes in air at 101 kilonewton per meter square, so that is the intake pressure. I'll write it in the data. So pressure P1 is given, and 150 degree Celsius, so that is temperature at inlet, temperature T1. It is 150 degree Celsius at 273. It gives us the answer in Kelvin, which is 423 Kelvin. Next, it is given the air is compressed to a pressure of 606 kilonewton per meter square. So this is the pressure after compression. So that is P2. Then, and it is given, and then pass through a regenerative heat exchanger. So just by reading this, that it is regenerative heat exchanger, we can say that the problem belongs to regeneration type. So here I'll mention the type of the problem. It is of regeneration type. So it means the compressed air is passed through the regenerator having of effectiveness 0.65. So effectiveness is denoted by epsilon. It is 0.65 for the heat exchanger. Then the air is then passed through a combustion chamber where its temperature is increased to 8700 degrees Celsius. So this is the temperature we are getting after the combustion chamber. So that is 8700 degrees Celsius. I'll convert it into Kelvin. So it is 8973 Kelvin by adding 273. Now this temperature, right now I'm not denoting it because I'll show it onto the diagram and then we can get the notation of this. Then the gases enter a turbine and are expanded to 101 kilonewton per meter square pressure. So this pressure which is given, that is after the expansion, or we can say at the exhaust of the turbine. So that pressure is 101 kilonewton per meter square. Then assuming compressor efficiency of 85% and turbine efficiency of 80%. So compressor and turbine efficiencies are given. Compressor efficiency is 85%. So divide this by 100, that becomes 0.85. And turbine efficiency is 80%. So that becomes 0.8. Then determine the following for air flow rate of 4 kg per second. So mass flow rate of air is given, that is m dot a. And these are the questions we have to find out. That is, we have to first find out power output of the plant. So power output is basically W net is what we have to find out. Next, exhaust temperature. So we have to find the temperature of the exhaust gas. So here I am writing T suffix exhaust, the temperature which we have to calculate. Notation, I'll show it onto the diagram. Then thermal efficiency of the plant. So we have to find out the thermal efficiency for this power plant. And at last, the question is thermal efficiency without heat exchanger. It means in the third question, we have to find thermal efficiency of the plant where we have to consider regeneration. In the last question, thermal efficiency without heat exchanger, it means regeneration is not there. So we have to find out the thermal efficiency in the last question, but this is without regeneration. So that's the question in front of us. Now into the solution part, I'll quickly draw the diagram, show the layout. Be quick while drawing the diagram. So here the atmospheric air enters at point 1. It gets compressed in the compressor. We reach point 2 or state 2. Then it enters this heat exchanger. So here is the heat exchanger, where the air gets heated, so we get state 3 out of this. Then it enters a combustion chamber. This is the combustion chamber wherein fuel is sprayed. So there is combustion, and after combustion we reach up to state 4, where the hot gases, they enter the turbine, and in the turbine we get the expansion of the gases. So we reach state 5. after the exhaust, and then the same exhaust is brought back into the heat exchanger at state 5, and it leaves the heat exchanger at 6, giving its heat to the compressed air which is coming from the compressor. So in this way, the heat supplied by the fuel goes on reducing and we get the high thermal efficiency. So for the notation part, in the question they had given the temperature after the combustion chamber as 8700 degrees Celsius. From the notation it is clear that temperature is T4. So here now I can denote it as T4, and the pressure after the expansion, so that is after the expansion means we reach state 5, so P5 is 101. So here we can write the notations. And then into the solution part, here I am giving a small hint, that important hint: in all gas turbine problems, calculate the temperatures first. So that is what we have to remember. We have to find all the temperatures first. Now when I see that during process 1 to 2, here we have isentropic compression, because nothing is mentioned about the type of compression. We can see that, say that it is isentropic compression. So for process 1 to 2, the relation is T2 upon T1, that is the temperature ratio, is P2 by P1, pressure ratio, raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Therefore, T1 is given to us, that is 423 Kelvin. Pressure P2, that is 606 kilonewton per meter square. P1 is 101 kilonewton per meter square. Gamma is 1.4. For air, you can take the value as 1.4 until and unless some other value is specified. Now on calculating this, I am getting the answer as, it is 705.78 Kelvin. So that is T2. Now in this problem, even they have mentioned that there is compressor efficiency. So for that, I'll draw the TS diagram and explain. Here we have isentropic compression from pressure P1 up to pressure P2. Now since the compressor efficiency has been given, this isentropic compression would not remain isentropic. It will deviate, and the deviation would be somewhat like this. Instead of 2, we are going to reach point number 2 dash. And so I'll find the next temperature, which is T2 dash, what is required. And for that, I'll use the small concept here. That is, since compressor efficiency is given by output upon input. So since the compressor efficiency will be equal to, now I'm giving again a hint here how to get that. See, take this small temperature difference, which is T2 minus T1 in the numerator, upon the greater temperature difference, which is T2 dash minus T1 in the denominator. So basically, when you are writing the efficiency, take the less temperature difference upon the greater temperature difference. Now therefore, compressor efficiency is 0.85. Temperature T2, 705.78, minus temperature T1 is 423. So therefore, on calculating this, my answer of T2 dash comes out to be, it is 755.68 Kelvin. Now after getting this temperature, that is the temperature after the compression process, now we can similarly find for the turbine. It means temperature T4 is given to us, so I'll be calculating the temperature T5 here. So I can say that similarly for turbine, that is process 4 to 5. Now like in case of compressor, I had written T2 by T1. Similarly here, T4 by T5 is equal to P4 by P5 raised to gamma minus 1 upon gamma. Therefore, T4 value is 8973 Kelvin upon T5 is equal to P4. Now, what is P4 over here? Since in this case, in the entire problem, nothing is mentioned about the pressure drop. So we can say that once we have compressed air at point number 2 dash, it goes into the heat exchanger. So it is a constant pressure heating. So we reach state 3. Similarly, when it enters into the combustion chamber, there also it is constant pressure heating. We reach state 4. Then at 4, it enters the turbine and then we get the expansion, which is isentropic expansion from 4 to 5. So here we have P2, P3, P4, all are same. And similarly, P1, P5 and P6, they are same. So at 0.5, it goes into the heat exchanger and then we get the drop in temperature from 5 to 6. Now, therefore, we can say that P4 is equal to P2, which is 606. P5 is equal to P1, that is 101. Gamma value is same, 1.4. So therefore, from this, I am getting the temperature T5 and my answer is, it is 5377.85 Kelvin. Next, even in this problem, they have given turbine efficiency as well. So it means what the temperature difference which we are getting here, this is an ideal temperature difference, or we can say the ideal enthalpy drop. But since efficiency is mentioned, so it is going to get deviated, and instead of reaching up to 0.5, we'll reach only up till here, that is 0.5 dash. So this difference, which is T4 minus T5 dash, is less compared to the difference which was there originally, which is T4 minus T5. This difference is greater. So it means less amount of enthalpy is available in this actual process from 4 to 5, and hence it means that if the enthalpy is reduced, then the work which would be developed by the turbine will also reduce. So we can write, now I have found out T5, similarly I will find T5 dash. For that I am again using the concept like I use for compressor efficiency. I will write down similarly, since turbine efficiency will also be given by less temperature difference. Clearly from the diagram it can be seen that the less temperature difference is T4 minus T5 dash, and the greater temperature difference is T4 minus T5. So now just go on putting the values here. Turbine efficiency is given as 80%, 0.8. T5 dash is what we have to find out. So my answer comes out to be, it is 6096.88 Kelvin. And this I can say that it is the temperature of the exhaust gases. So that is one of the answers. So the temperature of exhaust gases, it comes out to be 6096.88 Kelvin. So that's the first answer, because we had to find the temperature of the exhaust gases, and here it is T5 dash. Then the last temperature which is to be calculated is temperature T3. And for that, I'm going to use the effectiveness of the heat exchanger, and that can be written as that since the effectiveness of heat exchanger is given by, it is the actual rate of heat transfer upon maximum possible heat transfer. So the actual rate of heat transfer can be written as, it is T3 minus T2. So basically we have the actual heat transfer in terms of temperature, T3 minus T2 upon the maximum possible. Maximum possible means if this exhaust gas was in direct contact with the compressed air. So if there is direct heat exchange between 5 and 2, that is T5 dash, basically T5 dash minus T2, that would be the maximum temperature difference. So maximum temperature difference is T5 dash minus T2, and the actual temperature difference is T3 minus T2, which we are getting. Now putting the values one by one, so therefore, so from this I am getting the answer of T3, and its value is, it is 4209.99 Kelvin. Now once all the temperatures are known, we can easily find whatever has been asked in the question. The first part was, we have to find power output. For power output, we require both the compressor power as well as the turbine power. So first I'll write down that since power developed by the turbine. I'll denote it as W suffix T dot is equal to, it is mass flow rate of air, specific heat of air into the temperature difference, and in the turbine the temperature difference is, it is T4 minus T5 dash, that is the actual temperature difference. Then putting the respective values, mass flow rate of air given in the question, it is 4, specific heat of air standard value 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin, T4 8973 minus T5 dash 6096.88. So therefore, on calculating this, I am going to get the answer of power developed by the turbine, which is, it is 11.56 into 10 raised to 3, and the unit is kilowatts, because mass flow rate is in terms of kg per second, specific heat of air kilojoule per kg Kelvin, temperature difference in the form of Kelvin. So Kelvin Kelvin gets cancelled, kg kg gets cancelled, kilojoule per second is kilowatt. Now after getting the power developed by the turbine, I'll write the power consumed by the compressor. That since power consumed by the compressor is mass flow rate of air again specific heat of air and the temperature difference, in the compressor it is T2 dash minus T1, which is the actual temperature difference. So on calculating this, I am getting the power consumed by the compressor as, it is 1.337 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatts. So therefore, the net power output as mentioned in the problem, therefore, net power output will be equal to work developed by the turbine minus the work consumed by the compressor. So therefore, putting the values, it comes out to be 10.22 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatts, or we can simply say it is 10.22 megawatts by dividing it with 1000. So that's the second answer. Next, we have to find out the amount of heat supplied, because we want to calculate efficiency. So since heat supplied, and we have to only take that heat supplied in the combustion chamber, because there in the combustion chamber is there where we are supplying the fuel. So we have to find out heat supplied in the combustion chamber, and that heat supplied would be QS dot M dot A, and since mass flow rate of fuel is not given, it can be neglected, specific heat of air and the temperature difference in the combustion chamber. I'll show it onto the diagram. Air is entering at 0.3, leaving at 0.4, so the temperature difference would be T4 minus T3. So T4 minus T3. So therefore, the amount of heat supplied comes out to be, it is 19.15 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatts. So therefore, the thermal efficiency with regeneration will be output upon input. Output is W dot net, input is the amount of heat supplied which we are giving. So therefore, W dot net is the net power, which was 10.22 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatts. Similarly, heat supplied 19.15 into 10 raised to 3 kilowatts. So therefore, the thermal efficiency with regeneration will come out to be 0.5336, go up to, after the decimal go up to the four places and then multiply it by 100. So it is 53.36% with the help of regeneration. Now without regeneration, for that we can say that if regeneration process is not there, then the temperature difference would be, it would be directly T4 minus T2 dash. So that is without the heat generate, without the regeneration process. So therefore, heat supplied, this is without regeneration, so that will be M dot of air, specific heat of air, and directly it is T4 minus T2 dash, because T3 is not there since it is without regeneration. So 4 into 1.005. The temperature 8973 minus T2 dash, which was 755.68. So therefore the heat supplied comes out to be, it is 33.03 × 10³ kilowatts. So therefore the thermal efficiency, that is also without regenerator, would be, in the numerator W net will remain as it is, heat supplied this value we have to put, and we can clearly see that the heat supplied has been increased without regeneration, and now the answer is, it is 0.3094 or 30.94%. So it means we can clearly compare that with regeneration the efficiency is greater, and without regeneration the efficiency reduces. So this problem also proves that when we are having the regenerator, that is one of the method by which we can increase the efficiency of the gas turbine power plant. And with all the questions answered, the problem gets completed. At the end, if you'll find my videos helpful, you can like, share, comment and subscribe our channel and share it amongst your family and friends. Thanks for watching.